in eastern Montana, it's the Badlands, and so it's rolling hills to steeper hills and coulees and things. If you pick and choose your way, you can work your way out of stuff that normally it would take you several hours to pack, a deer or an elk out. You can do it this in an hour or two. What I like about the cart is it's small enough to where you can use it on multiple projects, whether it's, like a farm type use or construction or just yard work. I mean, sometimes you might have to have a fairly heavy piece of equipment to, let's say, move a rock into the backyard, but a bobcat can't get through the gate. You could load the rock on and, fit through a gate. If you have to clean out stalls, you can fit in between the stalls where a lot of times you can't get a bobcat or, anything motorized. Even if you have to pull a calf, I mean, it's got the winch. You could unpin the front wheel assembly, lay it down, winch the calf right onto the cart, and if you have to take them to the vet, the calf would never hit the ground. Just roll it right on into the horse trailer and off you go. I just use ATV ramps, to get it up into a trailer or a pickup. We have one video where our associate, with a big elk, rolled it right into the back of a regular four-wheel drive, and it was quite impressive because, this is with a big elk, and it walked it right on in. The length of the cart from the front to the back is 9 feet. It's 39 inches wide. The height is 44 inches to the top of the handlebar, and the weight is 180 pounds with one battery in it. And it will pack up to 600 pounds, depending on the grade and the terrain. If you're on rolly hills or whatever, I mean, it wouldn't struggle at all with 600 pounds. It's a two-battery system. One comes with the cart. You can purchase an additional battery if you would like the longevity of it. It does have a voltmeter. It's a 48-volt system, but fully charged, it'll charge up to 54 volts. So as you're going, you can always see what your voltage is on the meter. And if it gets down to where it's struggling with the pull, then you just flip the switch over to number two, and off you go. You don't even slow down. You just switch it on the run.
What I like about the cart is it's so versatile. The fact that you're done with the elk season or the deer season, then it's a piece of equipment that you can use readily around the farm or around the yard, to where it will do what you need to do as far as packing a load here and there without any much effort. So that was the unique things that we was trying to anticipate when we designed the cart, to do a multiple task piece of equipment. Now, if you're getting it into the hills and going after the game, I make the comment jokingly, of course, that I believe that thing would climb a tree if the bark isn't loose. In reality, when you get it out in the hills and start to work with it, it just takes the effort out of it. Simply follow the cart, guide it along the way. It does a fine job. It really does. You got 48 volts pulling you, and there's approximately 4 hours of mobility before you need to get close to a charger. It's built light enough to where it's plumb manageable with that assisted power, and yet it's built strong enough to where a 600-700-pound elk is not a problem. Basically, just turn up the throttle a little bit, start following it around, do your guiding thing is all you need to do. So it's really quite simple to run. It really is. Go on the website. Tom's phone number, my phone number is on there, and we'll sure try to help you out any way we possibly can. This piece of equipment can use in a lot of different areas.